Hi, I'm Kemba Roberg, and today we're going to learn to graph quadratic functions. Now, a quadratic function is a function with a squared x term. For example, y equals x squared. Now, anytime we're trying to graph a new function, it's a good idea to plot some points and see what the function looks like. We can use an xy table to do that. So what we're going to do here is choose some values of x and see what y would be. For example, negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, and 2. Now we plug these values of x over here into our function and see what y would be. Negative 2 squared is 4. 1 squared, negative 1 squared is 1. 0 squared is 0, 1 squared is 1, and 2 squared is 4. Now if we were to graph all of these, we would see a U-shaped pattern called a parabola. So this is actually the graph of y equals x squared. Now just like when graphing lines, it's important to remember that the graph continues beyond the points that we graphed. Let's look at a new function. This time, let's look at y equals 3x squared. We again can use an xy table . So we'll pick some values for x. And see what we get for y. Negative 2 squared is 4 times 3 is 12. Negative 1 squared is 1 times 3 is 3. 0 squared is 0 times 3 is still 0. And I'm actually noticing a pattern here. Notice that every value of y here is tripled to get our new value. And that makes sense. The only difference between these two functions is that this function has a x squared coefficient of 1. This function has an x squared coefficient of 3. So whatever we get here, we're tripling over here. So 1 tripled is 3. 4 tripled is 12. If we were to graph this, we'd end up with a graph like this. Now let's compare the two graphs we have. This one's the graph of y equals x squared. This one is the graph of y equals 3x squared. Do you notice any differences? It seems that this one is a much skinnier parabola, or narrower. Now let's look at the graph of y equals negative 3x squared. Notice these are exactly the same, except this one is pointing down. They have the same shape, they're just pointing in different directions. Finally, let's look at the graph of y equals 1/4 x squared, and we'll compare it to our first graph. Notice that both are pointing up, but this one is much wider. Let's draw some conclusions. When graphing functions in the form y equals a x squared, we can look at a. A tells us about the direction the graph's going to point, and also about how wide or narrow the graph is going to be. If a is greater than 0, that is, a is a positive number, the graph points up. So we'll put the parabola points up. If a is a negative number, that is, it's less than zero, the parabola points down. Now let's talk about how we can determine how wide or narrow the parabola will be. If the absolute value of A is greater than 1, we'll have a parabola that is narrower than the parabola y equals x squared. Finally, if the absolute value of A is less than 1, we'll have a parabola that is wider than the parabola y equals x squared.